Life is a journey made up of experiences, some good, some bad, some happy, some sad. We may all be different, but we're connected through the fact that no matter who we are, our stories all have hills and valleys. And so tonight, we dedicate this episode to those who fall from and are then saved by grace. Welcome to Sim Soul Sessions. And welcome to our show. Tonight, in our safe space, we talk to social media influencer and podcaster Kareem BwoyaTingz Weathers. But before we do that, we're checking in with one of our season two guests, my friend Ian IT Ellis. As always, you can join in our conversation tonight by using the hashtag SimSoulSessions. So with that, Ian, Sir IT, Mr. Ellis, good night, sir.
Oh, so many titles.
You've earned them all.
Whoa.
It's good to see you, my friend. How are you?
I'm good. You know, as I was coming on, I was saying, whoa, the mood I'm in now is so different from what I was in the last time we spoke here. You know, trust me. And so many months, so many weeks, so much time has passed, but you know, God is great. God is good. So I know.
Because when you were here, you had just gone through a bit of a rough patch. Yes. You had admitted for the first time that you were going through a bout of depression.
Yes.
Things were hard with business because of COVID. Yes. You mentioned the relationship with your son, which you wanted, yes, but you didn't have. Yes. And we spoke several times out of that program. But for the folks who are watching, catch us up. What's been happening?
Oh, a number of things has happened and is happening since then we spoke. I mean, let me look at business first. I mean, what we have done this year, even without a major new project, what we have done this year is really try to keep our space active on social media, you know, active space where our projects and products are monetized. So we keep that going monthly, weekly. So that's the business side. I mean, the personal side, the family side. I must quickly share that I'm now in constant dialogue with our family members, my son's grandmother and mother. We're trying to have some dialogue now, so I know the time is coming where we will have that. Prayerfully, we'll have that kind of dialogue. So that is good. My family, who I am with every single day, my daughters, my wife, oh, we are good. So much better than we were last year. So I really, really must quickly give thanks for that.
Tell me about the feedback you got out of the show, IT, because before that, most people would probably never have seen you in that light. You were always IT who was laughing and, you know, so yes, to share the depths of your soul like that.
Yes, I'm happy that you asked a question because before I came on, when it was being advertised that I was coming on, I got some calls, some persons who love me. And people were wondering, why is IT going on Sim Soul Session? Because perhaps in season two, the positioning of, and the brand of the show was still evolving. So they thought, if you're going on, something wrong. What is wrong? You know? And I tell you something, those same persons now want to come on Sim Soul Sessions to share, because the fact is, it's not only about trials, it's from trials to triumphs.
Exactly.
You celebrate triumphs after trials. So I'm happy to see how the show has grown and those persons who have come. I've met persons who have seen me on the road, completely, you know, to say, boy, you know, I have a similar situation. I realize that's why we must share our own situation. Sometimes they are so personal, we don't want to share them, but it can help reach, impact somebody. I have met men who have said to me that, boy, I have either a son or a daughter, who, you know, stories, complete strangers. But when I heard you share, I realized it's a common situation and I was encouraged to make contact, make a call, try again, awesome, and try and repair that. So I must say that's what came out of my experience on the show. And persons who were concerned that I was coming on call to say, you know, honestly, I was concerned, but when I watched the show, I was inspired. That word, this is Simone, I was inspired. I remember I said at the end of your show, at my show, that your journey to invite the stories from different persons in different backgrounds will be momentous, and it is already is, and is and continues to be.
So is that preached?
Yeah, Simone, you know, incidentally, if you look on Facebook and Greater Portmore Tabernacle, you will find a number of preaching sessions, you know. I'm not qualified, trained as a pastor, I'm not a deacon or anything like that. But, you know, I love the word, and the pastor knows that he involves me in the leading. I moderate, I share messages. And if you go online, you will find a number of them. So yes, is a short answer, or the long answer to that question.
Awesome. So you're in a much better place now.
Yes.
You see more light now than, you know, than darkness. You're no longer down in the doldrums. You are weathering the storms as they come.
Weathering the storm. And I have an active imagination. Now, I want to share a very active imagination with you, Simone, because I don't know where the imagination come from. Maybe it was a dream, but I was thinking that one day we'll wake up here in Jamaica and here across social media, traditional media, breaking news. The U.S. government has decided to collaborate with the Jamaican government to offer a U.S. visa to all fully vaccinated persons. Persons, all they need to do is present the vaccination card and they will get a U.S. visa, no questions asked.
The embassy would be run over. I don't know if they've had hands to do it, you know, but that could be breaking news you could use right now. Jeez, I'm crying. Yeah,
So that's, I'm inspired to think along these lines and to think about these things, you know. But I'm in a good place. I'm happy, I'm thankful, and I must encourage those. I'm being invited to do psychosocial sessions now, you know, with communities, work environment. Yes, I'm being called to motivate, to inspire, to pray with, to entertain, to create laughter, all in one place.
Fantastic.
So a new part of the dynamic is happening where my career is concerned. I'm very happy about that.
We are happy too, and we're glad you jumped in to catch us up this evening. Appreciate it, IT. Love you as always, and we'll be in touch, okay?
Yes, bless you, and keep going. I'm looking forward to celebrate 100, the first 100 episode with you. I'm waiting.
From your lips to God's ears, my friend. We'll keep at it. I'll invite you when it does happen, because it's going to happen. It's going to happen.
Yes.
All right, when we come back, thanks, IT. When we come back, we're going to talk to tonight's guest, Kareem BwoyaTingz Weathers, who's going to share his story with us. We'll be right back after this. Welcome back to the show, everybody. My guest tonight had it all until he didn't. And after a fast upward trajectory, he lost all he had gained, his mind almost as well, but he gained so much more in the long run that he is grateful for how it all played out. And he's here to share that story with us tonight. Kareem, welcome.
Thank you so much for having me.
It's good to have you. Kareem, yes. You've been manifesting for the last year.
Yes,
that
definitely.
You would be in that chair.
I made a tweet last year that I will be on the show, actually.
And you've had so many people from your community lobbying for you to be here.
They've tagged you in almost every single week.
Yes, I know.
It's like, Kareem needs to be on your show. Kareem needs to be on your show. Yeah.
I know you're here.
Yeah. No, I'm here.
Why did you think you wanted to be in that chair?
Because I know that, you know, I have a story, and each time I might tell just a little part of it. It touches a lot of people, and the feedback from a lot of people always coming, you know, to say, Kareem, thank you so much for sharing, or, you know, you sharing your story has helped me. So mm-hmm. I try my very best to be as open as possible, although I'm not as open.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. So for all intents and purposes,
yeah.
There could be people who are watching us right now mm-hmm. who would be looking on and saying, watch him now.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't know that boy there. You know.
Mm-hmm.
Not a good youth.
Right.
And you would say, as you told me,
yeah.
You were coming from a place where you were a horrible person.
Yes, I was. Yeah. And I can take that. You know, for me, accountability is a big thing, right? And I know a couple years ago, for persons who've been following me on social media, like, I had this condescending attitude and I wasn't the best of persons. I can say that. Somewhat of a bully. You know, I was very belittling. Like, I would berate you just for the most minute things possible. And I didn't feel any way, shape, or form about it. Now, with growth, I can look back at that and say, hey, you know, I was wrong. And I've made public apologies, you know, publicly on my platforms that, you know, if it is that I've affected you mentally, physically, in any way, shape, or form, you know, back then, I do apologize and I hope that you can accept that.
What was that about? Because you're coming from a place where you were Mr. It Guy.
Yeah.
Right? You had it all.
Yeah.
I mean, and all encompassed what? Tell me what your life looked like. And this was like about 3 years ago?
Just about four or five years ago, okay. Thereabout. For me, but then, having it all meant materialistic stuff. So having it all for me back then was the name brand clothes. And you know, anybody know Kareem back then? It was actually Kareem Big Dreams, right? And if you had a party, you want me to be there because, you know, the bottles and the excitement and the flair and the vehicles, like, that's what I was about. So for me, having it all wasn't even about peace of mind, because I didn't even know what peace of mind was then. I was just living. And for me, that was having it all. And, you know, if you were not within my social space, would I look down on you like, you know, why are you talking to me? Right? That was more so my attitude. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and God did it for the way I'm for the one.
So when did it get to that stage? Because you're raised in church.
Yeah.
Sing on church choir. You learn humility.
Yes.
And then?
I was raised in the church. I sung on the choir. I led youth services. I've been through it all. I think it happened after I migrated to the States and then I came back to Jamaica. And when I came back, I found the passion of promotion and I was doing events. And I think I just developed or adapted this personality. I'm not going to say that it wasn't me, because it wasn't an act, but in that moment, that was who I was.
And people change,
right,
and evolve.
So I developed that whole personality when I was doing events. For me, you know, the more you're out and the more you're in pitch two and the more attention you're getting and all of that, I think the nasty attitude, developed from that, mm-hmm. really and truly, because I was such a humble person growing up, mm-hmm. even in high school. You know, people can tell you, I was there, but I wasn't there. So I wasn't flashy growing up, nor, you know, like, had that personality until about 5-6 years ago.
Can you imagine the people who knew you before you left, and then when you came back, must have been like, who is this guy?
Right, I've lost all those friends.
You've lost them?
Yes, I think maybe about two out of those many people who I was friends with, like my friends from high school, I barely speak to anybody from JC. I barely speak to anybody from the church that I grew up in and spent like 10, 15 years of my life. Because when I came back, you know, that persona now and that personality, I didn't feel like you were serving me any purpose. And like, okay, well, we don't really have anything in common. So why would we need to be speaking, basically? So I don't really talk to anybody.
You will after tonight. Bet you.
Yeah.
Bet you.
Yeah.
So your turning point came.
Yes.
After you got what was a great job and you were in that job for a good while.
Yeah.
And then?
I was working in a corporate job for about 6 years, 7 years. So outside of being a promoter, I was in a great job. I had a great position there. I had a senior position. And funny thing is, looking back now, God was trying to slow me down for all those years, and I didn't even notice, right? So my first car, I had an accident, a major accident. Like, the car was totaled, and I walked out of that, not even a scratch. So he took that away from me years ago, you know, and I wasn't even noticing that he was trying to teach me a lesson. But then I was still working. Everything was going good. My events were doing fantastic. And I just remember January 30th, 2019, I got a letter that, a call for a meeting, and that the following day, my services won't be needed temporarily, they said, because of a company downsize, which I know that was not the case. And from then, everything just started to go downhill. Yeah.
After you lost your job.
Yes.
You knew you had lost your job.
Yeah.
But you were kind of like, meh.
Yeah.
You know, this will...
The day of January 31st, I remember getting the letter, right? Yes, I cried, but this was a good job. I was very passionate about it. I loved what I, you know, do. And I know that it was a malicious end on their end. So I was very bitter. But in my mind, I'm like, but I have my vents. Like, you know, I have different streams of income.
Okay. I got money.
Oh, well, yeah, like, what do you, right? So I was still living life. For people who are on my social media, they wouldn't even notice or realize that I wasn't working. So I was still traveling for months upon months upon months. And then one day I realized, wait, I'm broke. Like, you have $0 and 0 cents. And then I started to realize that what was happening. And I was like, well, your life right now, this is it. Mm. And what are you going to do?
Yeah, we're going to take it up from that point where you said you couldn't even get a haircut.
No.
Didn't even have $100 in your account?
No, not even $100 Jamaican.
All right. Yeah. Talk about his new state of being, which took him to a new low in his life. We explore that when we come back. Welcome back, everybody. Still with Kareem, who lost his job in January of 2019.
Yeah.
So February, you're flossing. March, you're flossing. Mm-hmm. April, breaks.
Right. April.
May-ish.
I was still seeing the signs, but I was still enjoying life. I remember the May of that year, my event, I kept Kingston 5 in New York for the first time, and that was my dream to bring my event international, right? And I remember... So people would see that event and think that everything was going good. I couldn't even find my part of the investment. So I was scuffling around. And then again, so it started to hit me. And then, you know, I was looking for jobs. I've been on a lot of job interviews. I have a lot of friends who are executives for a lot of company. But, you know, the old boss definitely decided that I was not going to prosper after. So I was jobless. I was seeking, definitely seeking.
Couldn't find anything.
It's just so funny because January of that year, I also started university to start back my degree for the seventh time.
And then seventh, like literally?
Yes, literally seventh. I started my degree locally and internationally about seven times. So that same January I started, and then, you know, for lose the jobs and all, whatever. And I remember one of my lecturers, she was like, hey, I work at a call center, but she works for NCB. She's like, I think that you would do great there. And I know that you can get like a good position, but you have to start off
at the desk,
at entry level. Mm-hmm. In my mind, I'm like, I'm definitely not doing that, right? But at this point.
Even at that point,
yeah, but still not humble. But what stood out to me, I was now looking at it like, I don't even have $100 Jamaican to my name, right? So I disappeared off social media just out of, I wanted a break also, but also out of embarrassment. So I deleted myself for about 6 months off the face of the earth. Nobody knew, not even my best friends, only my mother knew exactly where I was and what I was doing. No one could get in contact with me. And I remember starting to work at the call center, and remember, the end goal now, Kareem, you can come, you can get a good position, but you have to start here.
Right.
Fine, cool. Even in training, I remember people used to come to the training room door and wait and I take pictures. And the trainer used to say, what is happening? And they're like, that's Kareem Big Dreams, you know, like, you know, so Kareem Big Dreams is here, going to start taking calls. And then it kind of sink into me that, yo, okay, I could even eat lunch at that place.
You went to the cafeteria, the cameras are out.
Used to take my pictures in the cafeteria and post on social media, like, look who is here working. Like, look who has fallen from grace. You're so hype and you're there. So, like, that's what used to happen. And I decided that, well, this environment clearly cannot be for me, just for my sanity. I kind of felt like how I used to bully people back in the day. That's exactly what was happening to me. No.
Full circle, Kareem.
Right. And I left. I left after 2 months and I disappeared and I went to the country.
Mm-hmm.
Just trying to figure out what's going to happen. Simone, when I tell you, like, if I wanted a haircut, I would maybe have to ask my family members. You know, like, so now I'm a grown man at 29 years old. I can't provide. I can't assist in the house. I can't even, God forbid, if I got sick, go to the doctor. If something happened to my family, I couldn't assist it in any way, shape, or form. May I tell you, say, not even a bottle of water I could find. So I've had millions of dollars, and now you can't even find $100 Jamaican. When I say can't find it, there was no savings, there was nothing.
And on top of that, there are people who are celebrating your downfall.
There were people who were very happy for this.
Mm-hmm.
And I get it, but for me, I don't celebrate people's demise. But I understood where they were coming from.
Exactly, right. Because if they had suffered at your hands,
right,
and them say you're getting what them probably feel is karma, they'd be like, well,
they were happy.
You earned it.
They were celebrating and they were like, yes, this was supposed to happen. And
how, but do you, when you look back, do you realize how you blew through the money?
Going outside every day.
Outside every day.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like the clothes and the shoes and the excitement.
Like living like nothing changed.
It never come cheap. Like those things were expensive.
Yeah.
And I was just living. And I was thinking about it even coming here. And I said to myself, what was life then to me? I didn't even know what life was. I was just living. Right? So if it's not this brand or that, so that's how all that money
disappeared
at the snap of a finger.
So you left and went to the country.
Yes.
Couldn't really take care of yourself.
Right.
But in the space of a couple of months?
Yes, I was there for about 5 months.
You had lost 50 pounds.
Yes, I lost 50 pounds. I remember, so before I went there, and the reason I left is just because I could see the pain on my mother's face when I was going through that, you know, that depression. Like, I did not eat, I didn't come out of my room. And I said to myself that, you know, I could not allow myself to put her through that. So I went to the country and I lost a lot of weight, right? And it was through the stress and the trauma. I wasn't sleeping. People around me, clearly they're not going to really understand the pressure and say, no, I had to be faking like I was okay, but they knew, right? And I remember praying every single night that there was, asking God to take me off earth. I was saying, like how everybody would pray and say, thank you for this. I wasn't even thanking him for anything. I'm like, God, just remove me. Because why do you have me here going through all of this? Like, at this moment in time, I had no reason to be alive. And I prayed and I prayed and I prayed. And I remember one day, I got so angry with him, like, why are you not answering my prayers? Like, why are you not just... A slow death
what
is
did you
okay.
Want, you,
I just wanted to leave Earth.
You wanted him to leave
because I was just like, what is my purpose of living? And also, I was just looking at, I didn't think that I could bounce back from that, any at all. You know, living there, if I wanted anything, I could have asked my family members for it, you know. And I know a lot of my friends would say, you know, call your father, or, you know, why you don't go back to the States? But something within me was just telling me that, well, that was not what you were supposed to do. And I was very stubborn in that. So I was just here, just wasting away. I felt like I was just wasting away my life.
Mm-hmm.
And I felt like God just had me here because he wanted me to suffer. That's how I felt every single night.
So you thought he was punishing you?
I thought he was punishing me. And I said it to him, and I said that, I think that you're being selfish, putting me through all of this right now.
You told God that he
I pray, because when I'm praying, I pray like I'm talking to somebody. So I'm like, listen to me. You're pushing me through all of this because you're punishing me. And clearly you hate me. And that's why you have me here, you know, going through all of these trauma. And I know people go through things, but I'm like, I don't deserve this. Like, I don't deserve to be going through all of this that you're putting me through. And I will cry day in and day out. And I'm not even an emotional person, right? So anybody know me, knowing that even just sitting here speaking about this, it really and truly is like a 180.
Mm-hmm.
But God had a purpose for me.
Well, let's talk about that on the other side now.
Yeah.
I'm back with Kareem after this. Welcome back, everybody. So before the break, Kareem was telling us God had a purpose for putting him through what he was going through. During the first lockdown that we had, you decided you were going to get back on social. And open up a little bit about what you were going through. Right. What prompted that decision?
Little bit before the whole COVID thing happened, I came back to Kingston about December 2019, January 2020. And, you know, a family member helped me. And I started this online boutique and I did a whole name change. So from then now, I was, you know, rebranded myself and I understood exactly what was happening. So that BwoyaTingz Weathers was selling, you know, like online clothing. Things looked like it was going on up and up. I was like, yes, love this. And then 2 months in March, remember COVID started. So we were going through the lockdown. And at this moment now, I'm like, don't tell me that I'm going to go back through what I'm coming from. And, you know, no clothes, no sell. It's a pandemic. So we were going through the lockdown. And like anybody else who was very much confused as to the unknown was so scary. I remember doing one or two look at Instagram lives, right? And all my years of being a social media influencer, I've never done any Instagram live or anything like that. And it was about 20, I was like 20, 30. And we were just playing some random games, Never Have I Ever, ABC Fast, so just to kind of get our mentals off, you know, what exactly was happening. Yeah. And I remember people, they were so intrigued by it. And I was saying to myself, what is this for you guys, you know, to want to, you know, sit down every single night listening? And I did it for like 2 weeks. And something said to me one day that I must make it more structured. So I had a topic and you know, I had some guests and I called a couple of my friends. I was like, I know, call in and talk about your stories. And that, before I even came off that live, it went viral. So there were thousands of persons on it now. And I remember coming off the Sunday and a friend said to me, Kareem, I think that you should do podcasting. I think that this is your lane, that there's a niche, you know, clearly nobody else, you know, has this personality. And I've never watched a podcast back then. I'm not a YouTube type of person. So I didn't know who to call, but I made some calls and I made it happen. And the Wednesday of that same week, I did my first episode. It wasn't easy. Things happened behind the scenes. I was still thinking about where the money going to come from.
Well, you still think about that some days, right? When you shoot, right?
And I mean, even now, but you get it done. And I remember when all the things were happening, it's like something in me was saying that, you know, just still continue. Because I remember praying one time, and I don't know if it's God literally said to me that, you know, everything is going to be okay. Just keep going. And I remember crying my eyes out. So when I started the journey and I started my podcast, and it wasn't the conventional media platform, but I just knew it felt right to me. It felt like this is exactly what you're supposed to be doing. This is your niche. And
it felt like purpose, which is what you had been seeking.
Yes.
And so here now, you've stumbled into this thing where you realize you are a voice for many of your generation. And you were like, aha, this feels like where I'm supposed to be.
It did. But still, it felt like, okay, this felt good. And, you know, in my first season, we spoke about mental health. And that was the first time I was, you know, speaking out about my own journey just a little bit. And we spoke about so many things. I had sexual abuse victims on my show and they were voicing their stories. And when I saw how many people reached out to me and saying, Kareem, no matter what the topic is, no matter how entertaining it might seem, you don't know what day I was having. You don't know what you're doing for me. You don't know what you've done when you've touched on this topic or that topic.
You saved
and
my life.
And a lot of people reached out to me. I was like, yo, you saved my life. Like, I was on the brink of suicide. I was on the brink of this, and I wanted to end my life. And here you are giving me purpose and hope.
It's the power of the platform.
It's the power
of the personality.
Yeah.
Which has now migrated to radio. You do radio on a Tuesday night.
Yes.
News talk. And you feel like maybe you went the long way around to find where you're supposed to be. So when you say God had a plan in our last segment, you think that plan was to humble you?
Yeah, and he did. And I needed to be humbled. I needed it. Because if it wasn't for that, definitely I would not have these platforms. I would not be sitting here right now speaking my story. I would not be, you know, someone who's vocal about mental health. I would not even care much for those things, you know. I was an emotionalist person. I was just going through it. So my plan and purpose was to also be a voice and also give the voiceless a voice. Because a lot of my guests and a lot of topics that I speak about, you know, are things that our generations don't even have the platforms or the mediums to express how they feel. So to see that that's where I am at now, a lot of times I get choked up about it.
Yeah.
And I'm so appreciative because I'm like, no, I understood exactly why I had to go through all I had to go through so that I can even be more grateful for things.
Yeah.
Simone, right now, if you just give me this cup right here, I'm so grateful for
you
it.
You can have a cup.
Thank you.
But the show just goes to show.
Like, yeah. I'm just so grateful. It's just this emotion of gratitude now for life in itself and for everybody around me and for my opportunities. Believe me.
Yeah. Gratitude, forgiveness, lots of words we throw around, but they're very important. Somebody had a message that they wanted to share with you today. Yeah. Go ahead, Lord.
Our relationship did not start on the amazing foot that it is on now. But, you know, with growing and evolving and changing, here we are. Here we are, and I wouldn't have it any other way. If we had to relive that time, I would relive it the same way. It was so important for you to grow and learn and for me to grow and learn. And I love that for us because it's all about the growth. It's the growth for me, Kareem. And honestly, I forgive you and I love you so much, friend. I forgive you because you're such a humble person and you are one of the few people that I ever met that I had a poor interaction with that actually was brave enough, straightforward enough to come and apologize to me. And I appreciate that. I forgive you and I love you forever and ever and ever, friend. You always will have a friend in me. You can always count on me. I will always be cheering for you anywhere, anytime. Call me, if you want to reach me. Boy, it's Tings. Continue to be Tings, Kareem. You got this. You got this.
Wow.
So the backstory there, for those who don't know.
Yeah.
You used to make her life miserable.
I bullied that girl for years, endlessly. I know of her. At that time, she wasn't even doing YouTube or anything. And I used to bully her. And I remember, I think this was our first interaction or someone had said to me prior to meeting her, you know, she was like, you know, I stress ate and I gained a lot of weight because of Kareem. And Kareem didn't even know, you know, how much, like, he caused me so much pain and stuff like that. And when I used to be a bully, it's like an army of people used to be around me also doing the same thing. So it's not like it was just me alone. Everybody else was now bullying this one person. And it, when I saw that she actually took my apology, I am just like, you know, thank you so much. Because I know for one, I don't think I could have like forgave you that easily. I caused you public trauma, like public shame. There were thousands of people who laughed at you. There are thousands of people who bullied you because I set them on you, basically. And here you are, just one conversation in, saying, Kareem, I understand that was years ago. And, you know, you're not that same person and I forgave you. That for me was, yeah.
I know
Believe me.
That's great. But it takes, you see, a lot of people could not say what you just said.
Yeah.
Because they hurt people and they leave it be
without
any full circle.
Definitely.
Are you grown?
I have.
You're growing.
I have. I am still growing. I mean, I'm not there yet and I still, you know, fall down sometimes as it relates to my personality trait and things like that. But I know that, again, it's a whole 180.
Work in progress.
Believe me.
Work in progress, but you have support along the way.
Yeah.
Go ahead, madam.
I just want to send love and appreciation to my cousin, affectionately known as Don. And I just want to say how much I love what you're doing and appreciate the platforms you're using to bring to light those topics that persons may not feel comfortable talking about. But these are things we need to talk about. And I just want to say, you know, you use adversity and make it into an opportunity. And life is filled with ups and downs, but it's not what we do in those down moments, but how we rise from that. And you have proven to a lot of us that, you know, you are a go-getter, you are a winner, because no matter how many times you're knocked down, you get up.
I mean, this video is just to tell you how proud I am of you, how proud I am of your growth. I mean, me and you know the struggles that you've been through, the highs, the lows, the hurdles that you crossed to be here. I mean, I was there firsthand to see how distraught you were, going through so much things. And I'm just here to say that, yo, you're doing great. Continue to do what you do, continue to put God first, and always strive for excellence, my brother. You have been winning so far, so there's only more winning to come. I mean, words can't express how proud I am of you. I've seen you transformed into this mogul from a party promoter. I mean, I was there from the inception, so seeing it come to fruit has been amazing. I just want to tell you that you're doing great. Continue. You don't know you're my boss already. Big up every time. And I'm here to see you achieve what the world has for you.
So first and foremost, I am incredibly proud of you. Everything that you're doing now is everything you've dreamed about. And it's amazing to see how much you're flourishing and how much you're happy. I love that you're so happy. Every roller coaster you've been through, they've been there to witness it, and I'm so glad to call you my big brother because I am incredibly proud. I love you with all my heart, and everything that you've been through, I just want to say it doesn't matter because I'm always going to be proud of you as a mentor, a little sister, and my role model.
I am so proud of you. You're so blessed. You have a village behind you. Your amazing team, your family and friends. We're all so proud of the man that you have become. I am so honored to be a part of your journey, to watch you grow into the man that you are today. It has been beautiful, and I'm so happy that I'm on this ride with you. We always tell each other that God gives his hardest battles to his strongest soldiers. And as cliche as that might sound, you have continued to prove the truth behind that statement.
Just wishing you all the best. It's so nice to have met you. I just think you're a hardworking, ambitious young man. I wish you all the best. And I hope you could get me through this. Kareem BwoyaTingz, Miss Kitty GwoyaTingz, love you. I pray for abundance, health, wealth, and strength. And may God continue to bless you. Just continue to be your authentic self. You're not going to be able to please everybody. But once you are true to your purpose, once you are true to your mission, you will always be on the right path.
Trending boss. You see the thing with Kareem now? Kareem is the guy who can talk to a pastor and then talk to a prostitute.
Oh, Jesus.
And the two of them leave saying, yo, that guy is a great guy.
Yeah, so true. I mean, Kareem, I personally want to big you up for having the tough conversations. The conversations that most people would shy away from, but that we all want to hear about. Like, thank you for being so brave and, you know, really being curious about how people live. It's such a beautiful platform you've created, and we're really proud of you. So keep going. We need more of that.
And we need some more of those videos with you dropping into the bush.
100%.
More time I don't, I just look back on the video there,
I
and just,
the
it just
day.
Make my day feel so much better. Big up yourself, bro. Respect.
You're a great son, you're an excellent son. You're a son that every mother would want to have for their son. I love you dearly. You're a big dreamer. You work hard, you dedicate yourself. You're a purpose child. I love you with every breath. You have big dreams, and I know you're getting there. Continue to be the child you are, and you will reach your goal. I love you, baby boy.
So continue to, you know, do what you're doing in fashion. Love, much love. Sending your way, hon. Love you. Bye.
Continue to do what you do. Big up, my Bridging. All the best.
Thank you for just being you, and I love you so much.
Enough love, big up your nice clean self. For oh God bless, no man curse. Thank Father God, Kareem BwoyaTingz could never be the worst. La 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 la. Love you. Mwah. Bless.
Yeah. I don't want to disturb Mr. Bowden at all.
It's okay, it's okay.
Yeah, that.
Those that are joyous tears. I think
That means a lot, especially my family and friends. Well, I don't know how to get them, but yeah. But those means a lot because, you know, and I said this to you, that when I was on top, I had a myriad of an army of people behind me, and there were people that I called for help, and I can count on my one hand how many persons actually wanted to help or tried to help, you know.
So you said to me, the people in my circle were not the people in my corner.
No, they were not. And God had to prove that to me and take me out of all of those situations. So to see those people saying all of that to me, believe me, it moves me, especially for my mother.
Yeah.
Because my why is definitely her, and my why is definitely to... Clearly, I can't repay her for all that she's done and sacrificed for me, but my why is just to see her say, yo, I'm so proud of you. Mm-hmm. She supports every single thing. She watches and listens every single week. So that alone means everything to me, believe me.
A mother's love, my friend. Well, all right, when we come back, we find out where Kareem goes from here, where he is, and where he's going from. We'll be right back. Wrapping up with Kareem, so tell us where you are now, steadily building back. You say you have the days when you wonder, when will the house come, when will the car come, but...
Yeah. Steadily building. I'm in a better place mentally, although there are days when I am definitely out of it. As I've shared with you, my platform and all that I'm doing right now, it is not cheap at all, and it comes straight from your pocket, and you don't have a 9-to-5, so sometimes you're wondering, you know, how are you going to make it work, and you have responsibilities, and will I have to sacrifice paying this bill because I have to make sure that I'm producing my content, right? So that's where I'm at. Financially, nowhere close to where I was or even where I want to be. Yes, I have staff, I have people to pay, I have content to produce every single week. So it is hard, definitely, definitely hard, but I would take this hard over 2019 hard. And I've seen progress. Like, I've collaborated with a lot of family brand. When I started this, enough people tell me, say,
nope.
Your content, definitely not. I can't see you on the radio, or nobody would want to work with you. There are some family brands that have collaborated with me. Thank you so much to them as well. And even News Talk for even giving me a chance. Mm-hmm. Like, a lot of people told me that I would not even be here a year after. I'm 5 seasons in my podcast.
Yeah.
That is over 50 plus episodes. So all the no's and all the naysayers, I don't really pay attention to that. I'm more paying attention to the love, right? To see me trending every single week, no matter what it is. My support system, my internet support system, them call themselves Tings Nation. Believe me. So I'm there. The radio thing is doing very well as well. You know, my manager, Cassie, I know that you don't really like the attention, but, you know, I must say thank you also to her. She is behind me 100%. And my goal is to not just be, well, you know, he was hot for a minute. My end goal is to be definitely a mogul. I want to be a household name.
Sustainability.
Right, so it's going to be TV, it's going to be radio, it's going to be YouTube, it's going to be the podcasting thing. So I want to conquer media from each and every different angle because my outreach and every host, I just want me to tell you the truth. Because if you don't watch a podcast, you must watch a TV. If you don't watch a TV, then you must listen to the radio. You know, and my content is for everyone. Like, you can go on my platform and no matter whom you are, or how conservative you are, you can find something for yourself. So that is my aim, and I'm going to be doing that.
You're grateful that everything happened because it brought you here.
Yes, sometimes I might just kind of slip back, but I'm grateful for everything that happened because I'm here. I'm on Sim Soul Session. Come on, like, this is a huge deal for me, and you don't even understand. Like, I have it even in my notes right now, things that I wanted to happen for this year, and here I am. So, you know, thank you so much for also giving me, you know, to share a piece of your platform, and I am greatly appreciative
of you
as well.
Thank you for sharing with us. I mean, there is beauty in your story.
Yeah.
You know, you can be redeemed. You can change and use your platform for good.
Definitely.
And we don't often have a lot of men on this show who are willing to be vulnerable and to open up. And so we're grateful.
Thank you.
And we know we're going to see big things from Kareem in the years to come. So as I've said to you, be ready to receive what you have prayed for.
Definitely.
Okay?
Yes.
So can I do my affirmation now?
Yes.
All right. So now it's time to wrap things up with our affirmation for tonight. They say pride goeth before a fall, but that doesn't mean that you have to stay down when you do. To get back up again is difficult, and it takes will, but it's an opportunity to learn the lesson and start over with a more humble and contrite spirit. Who have you hurt? What have you destroyed? You can apologize. Rebuild those relationships, including the one you have with yourself. Ask for forgiveness, including from yourself, so that you can put any broken pieces of your life back together again. The mistakes are only bad if you don't learn from them. Life's greatest lessons are often the most painful, but they allow us the most growth, and for that, we have to be grateful. So tonight we are affirming, I will allow my struggles to serve me. That is our soul food for tonight and our show for this evening. Thank you, Kareem, for being here with us. We'll be back next week with another story of the amazing power of the human spirit. Until then, every blessing, and please remember to count your blessings. Night, everybody. Take care.